turns out as of today, and the world is meant to end today. What's a bunch of baloney?
Hey!
Oh, hey, Navi, what's up?
Listen!
What? You want me to go outside and look at something? Okay. Well, we're screwed. It's a vlog.
Nah, the world's not going to end today, little and clickbaiting as it is. Thanks, Internet. Anyways, hi, I'm Steamwalker and Steety Films. It's a vlog. So, what videos I did this past 1 week? Not only did I did one, not two, but three. Three videos that I did this past 1 week, even though one of which I kind of did like a filler type video. It was a nice edited video that I did, even though I mainly did it for a particular theory, because I did say a few vlogs ago that I was going to do a particular theory, even though using Bluetooth headphones like these £20 skull candies that I got, little and the cheap method on getting Bluetooth headphones, and it is, you know, using the bullet mic for the Xbox One to be able to chat. If you haven't checked out the video, do check out so you know about my theory, saves me talking about it. But it was a nice video to do, even though that I didn't expect to get the two particular items that came up this past 1 week, because I was unsure if I'd be able to get something, even though originally I was going to get Pokken Tournament, because I did say I was unsure to get Pokken Tournament, let alone double dipping, even though I got the Wii U version as it is. But it was nice though, because I end up using whatever spare change that I had since after getting stuff on my sister's birthday. I did kind of say, oh, I might get the Creeper controller, and I end up getting the Creeper controller as well as Pokemon Silver, and that came out just yesterday as of this recording. But yeah, even though that turned the Minecraft Creeper controller didn't do so well, even though I thought I'd be the first lot of people and to be able to unbox it kind of deal, even though it, like I said, it came out last week in the US, I guess the Microsoft stores in the US, I guess. But anyways, Pokemon Silver, however, I didn't expect to get that much people viewing, because it did very, very well just yesterday in general. So I'm really pleased, even though that I'd done well in viewing, I got somewhat feedback, which is quite nice. But still, however, it was nice to get the, you know, physical retail box, because I just said in the video, I don't want to explain too much here, but I was quite long-winded in the video. I was just having a really nostalgia overload in terms of getting Pokemon Silver. It was just nice to get it though, instead of, you know, getting the digital copy as it is, even though I'm struggling to get back into my 3DS as another thing. But it was a nice pickup to get, nice physical cardboard thing, you know. And I just didn't expect to get that much feedback in terms of people viewing, and it's gone like nearly over around 500 views already. So yeah, thanks for those people that watched it, and little newcomers it is. And thank you for all the newcomers, I thought quickly mentioned. Thank you to all the people that recently knew and subscribed recently as well, I just thought I'd mention about that. But whew, yeah, so those are the kind of videos I did this past 1 week. So for this vlog, I want to discuss about some stuff about my mobile devices, which are these that I have, which is my Windows phone, my Android tablet, and plus my iPod, even though, as of this past 1 week, I currently recently updated my iPod Touch 6th generation to the latest update, and it's iOS 11. Which I can currently installed on my iPod. Don't worry, this isn't like a screenshot or anything, because it does have the new control center thing, you know, so you can like boop and then boop. Don't disturb me while I'm doing a vlog, because I tend to put the, because YouTubers need to do that. Yeah, like sort of mobile devices, you need to make sure you're not disturbed. Well, and I doubt Mum will bring me when I'm doing my vlog is another thing. She usually texts me, then ringing me. Anyways, but yeah, it's nice that I got iOS 11. It's quite neat in terms of some nitpicks I realised, because I'm so used to the previous OS, iOS 10, because when iOS 10 came out, there was like no function to be able to slide to unlock. You know, it's like, hey, what? How do I slide to unlock and all that? And you know, I'm so used to it now in terms of because you know this doesn't even have a fingerprint reader, let alone, you know, a physical button is another thing. You know what I mean? But overall, yeah, it's just a nice feature in terms of you know, updating my iPod is another thing. Even though you know, my predicament ecosystem in terms of owning certain devices to try out all the operating systems on Windows Phone as it is, because I know most of you will be like, well, why do you have a Windows Phone even though you should get like an Android or iPhone in general, because I know I have a weird ecosystem, because I had this weird ecosystem for many, many years in terms of trying out all the operating system, alone BlackBerry as it is. Who owns a BlackBerry these days, even though the latest BlackBerry has like stack Androids as it is, if you know what I mean. But I do like using my tech as it is. I know my ecosystem is very, very dull, so to say, even though I've been having this conversation with Adrian, because he's planning to get the latest iPhone as it is, even though he was going to get an Xbox One X originally, even though he might save up for both, what to say. I don't want to explain about his personal life too much, but the reason why he's getting the latest iPhone, because he's doing some app development in his uni and stuff like that. Yeah, I should really show up about that. But you get what I'm trying to say. It's understandable why he wants to get the latest iPhone as it is. But we have this been having this conversation for the past 2 weeks since the iPhone X was announced. Well, it's not X, it's 10. You know what I mean. But, you know, since the iPhone 10 was announced, and we've been like non-stop discussing, like, Stephen, you should really get yourself an iPhone and stuff like that, because he's currently running Android as it is, because he wanted an upgrade. But he was like, why don't you get a phone, Stephen? Well, I do have a phone. I have a Windows phone, even though there's not much like apps that support. And mainly, you know, my daily driver has always been my iPod, because I like using iOS, because it's like, you know, simplistic, I should say, OS. And it's, even I do go on my Android now and again. I do have an Android device in terms of tablet is another thing, even though that I do have a Windows 10-inch tablet that I got for £50. So that whole different thing, that breaking my ecosystem a little bit with owning a Windows 10 10-inch tablet, even though that doesn't even have the latest OS in terms of the Creator update for Windows 10 for my, you know, 10-inch tablet is another thing. But, you know, why can't you just have the one phone device, even though that, currently, my sister, get this right, she was meant to have a new phone since her birthday, but she didn't get one, because her current iPhone, even though it's running, should be running the latest OS, because at the same time when I upgraded to iOS 11, my sister should be upgraded to iOS 11, because she has the iPhone 5S, and surprisingly, that after 3 years, because Adrian shared me an article about that iPhone in general, the iPhone 5S has been like out for like almost 4 years, and it's still receiving updates. But it'll discontinue next year in terms of that. But by the time that will discontinue, my sister will have a new phone as it is, because she was thinking of maybe upgrading to a Samsung in terms of that, let alone. My Android tablet as it is really discontinuing updates in terms of what was the previous update? I know the latest update is Oreo. I forgot what the other one was. I forgot what the previous update was, because I lost track on updates. But I know I have Marshmallow on this. Oh, it was Nugget. Yeah, I think it was Nugget. Yeah, the previous operating system was Nugget. I got back on track of updates now. But yeah, I have Marshmallow. Didn't receive the Nugget update, but I know we're up to a current point at Oreo in terms of Android operating system. So yeah, my Android tablet is really discontinued, but I can still operate certain apps in terms of my tablet as it is. But I've been thinking about this for the future of my devices in terms of, because I've been having this conversation with Adrian, like I said, in terms of my ecosystem. It is, I had to break my ecosystem at some point. I know, because I'm really picky in terms of my autism as it is, if you know what I mean. But at some point, a later date, I don't think Apple are making a new iPod, and Windows phones will be like dead before you know it, because there was a rumor at first that they were working on the Surface phone, but they're like, nah. So at some point in a later date, I might have to get rid of these. I'll still keep these devices. I mean, like, I have to like split up with these and maybe just get a new phone in general, because I'm really unsure, because I'm quite picky, because I really want to try all the operating systems, even though mostly on my iPod, in terms of iOS. I do use my Windows phone, not all the time, that's why it's so good on battery life, because I rarely use it, because I usually toggle the Wi-Fi on and off when I don't use it, and I toggle my 3G on and off is another thing when I don't use the phone. I don't usually hardly use this phone, because I usually have a good battery life for because I don't have to charge it. I have to charge it every 2 days, and it's good battery life because I rarely use the phone. Because if I did use it constantly, then yeah, the battery would have died out in terms of using my Windows phone constantly. Like, you know, because using my iPod constantly in terms of my camera for my videos is another thing. But it has been like 2 years now since the iPod Touch 6th generation came out. And it would be nice if Apple would announce a new iPod, which is doubtful though, even though it will come up to the end of this year as it is. But even though an article just a few months ago, I thought I'd quickly mention, just a few months ago, they discontinued the iPod Nano and iPod Shuffle line, but they're still selling iPod Touches. So there might be a chance to be able to have a new iPod, which is doubtful though. But, you know, my battery is depleting. It's been 2 years since I had this iPod. So maybe they might do one, because it's usually every 2 years I usually upgrade my iPod. Even I still have my own last generation iPod, because I have the fifth generation. Yeah, because it's still the same as this as the sixth generation, even though it's in slight improvements. But I could just do a new iPod, even though it's the cheapest way to get into iOS is another thing, let alone, you know, in terms of buying a cheaper iOS device. But then again, the updates will discontinue is another thing. So I'm really picky with my ecosystem. I at some point I have to break the ecosystem in terms of getting another device. And, you know, I hate with these devices these days, you know, what Apple and Samsung like. It's like, yeah, we got the latest flagship phones as it is. They cost a bundle as it is. Well, then again, my mum would approve it, because at the end of the day, it's my money. And if my mum approves, it's like, yeah, you can have a new phone, even though I had this conversation one time with my mum about my phone. It's like, oh, are you sure you don't want a new phone, Steve? It's like, no, I'm all right. I'm quite happy with my Windows phone. So she knows if I want a new phone, I can get a new phone. But I'm just quite happy with my ecosystem, as I said. You know, it's the goddamn Asperger's autism in me that likes to be like, yeah, I want to try all the operating systems. Well, having multiple devices to try out all the operating systems, even though most of my iOS device, is a whole different thing. So it's what I've been up to this past 1 week. I had a great week, even as you can kind of tell, I got some kind of new things, even though I got some pickups from Amazon, which I'll mention about in a bit. But yeah, as you kind of tell, I kind of got like this new jacket, raincoat thing, because I was hunting down, right, guess what, I was hunting down for a particular raincoat, but I'm quite picky on certain things, because I don't want like an Adidas or some kind of a Nike or some kind of unbranded raincoat in terms of that, because I was looking in sports direct, but there was like some branded ones. Like, no, I don't want a branded one. I don't want to look too chabby, because even though I do have a proper raincoat that's quite chabby, a chabby 90s, you know, white stripes and all that, you know, a proper chabby one. Even though this doesn't look kind of chabby, even though I'm trying to keep up to date with the latest, not saying trends or style. But knowing me, I do like my geeky t-shirts as it is, even though I put this on, as you can tell, I pooped. I thought it seems suitable for this vlog, even though it's the only kind of iOS, I guess, you know, t-shirt. Anyway, it's gone off topic, but you know what I mean, I kind of wanted like a newish thing, even though that I can have plenty of hoodies as it is, even though that I did ordered them, because my mum was very nice, because at the end of the day it's out of my account, and my mum said you can have whatever you want in terms of because I was thinking about getting a raincoat, because there's been the change of seasons, even though it has been on and off weather lately since the change of seasons, because we're below 20 now, 20 degrees now, and it's time to start wearing certain things, even though getting some new things, because you know what my mum's like in terms of we need you to get new clothes for the winter and stuff like that. You know what my mum's like, even though, like I said, at the end of the day, it's out of my account. So I was looking for a raincoat, and I decided to get this raincoat, even though it looks like a nice hoodie, jackety type thing. But it's a proper raincoat, so it will keep me dry, even though I have an awkward thing of just putting these sleeves up, trying to make me look cool. Well, I'm like a chav as it is. Innit, mate? Chav, innit? Well, then again, so I have a military cap, not a baseball cap. anyways. But yeah, overall, it's just nice to pick up this nice jacket, raincoat, and I recently ordered another stripy hoodie. Because as you may know, I like wearing my stripy hoodie, even though that my mum said I could have a second one, and we recently got some Amazon credit. I had more Amazon credit than I expected, because I did say to Mum, at some point I need to refresh my cap because it could do a refreshing. And my Mum said, oh, here, I have an extra credit towards the cap and all that, even though I was planning to get a cap out of my weekly allowance in next week. But it was nice, very nice, thank you, Mum. But then, like I said, at the end of the day, it's out of my account. But yeah, I'm getting to plan to refresh my hat also, even though the patch just came today. As you can see, even though I got this patch a few years back, but it's the same patch I got a few years back. Even though the last time I ordered a Zelda patch, as you can see, it's quietly smaller. Well, not saying, well, yeah, it's quietly smaller, but this one's quite bigger because it was a different seller that I ordered. But yeah, this will be nice, easy sewing, because as you can see, when my mum sewed this up, it was slightly a bit off in terms of excess stuff on that. Sorry for my messy hair. But yeah, nice to get this patch, even though I ordered some other things I had on my wish list that I decided to get round to ordering. Sadly, the hat didn't came today, because I was expecting to get the cap also today. But hopefully I'll get that on Monday, so I'll get round to sewing this up. Even though I can't order the Halo patch no more, because the cell wasn't selling the Halo patch no more. But I have some spare caps that have the Halo patch, so I can always my mum can always unsew that and sew it, because I've got a spare cap that has a Batman logo on the opposite side. I can always use that. I'm planning to do I might have to do that in terms of I can't buy the Halo patch no more. Anyway, it's gonna talk about patches, but yeah, I'm looking forward to getting my refreshing cap as well as my hoodie, because my hoodie should come next week. But in the meantime, I'm just enjoying all the essential things I kind of bought on Amazon, because I ordered some stuff that I had on my wish list, because I bought some nifty little things. Even this really off-score thing that I actually got for under £3, even though it's like £2.70-ish. But I decided to order this, and it's, I had a little go on it today, and I'm just setting it all up in terms of But I actually ordered this that came today, and it came in a nice box, a nice packaging box. And that is this wireless nunchuck adapter, which is quite cool. You can get some wireless nunchuck adapters, but I think the reason why I ordered this for £2.70, it came with some very acety batteries. I tried to be careful in terms of the packaging, but it was a nice product overall. I didn't look up on any YouTube reviews in terms of an old Wii product, I should say, but here it is. It's a nice wireless nunchuck in terms of playing with a nunchuck. I know it looks like a knuckle duster, and it may, you know, and all that. But yeah, it's just a nice like knuckle duster type shape thing. And it's a weird thing how you just put the nunchuck in, even though the you know, wiring as it is on the inside, because it's a bit awkward, because I had to read the instructions. A good thing it came with instructions, like, how do you do this? And I read the instructions, because it came with instructions after dealing with the acety mess in the packaging. But it does work, though. Had a little go with it in terms of I managed to get proper batteries with this, because I'm using whatever batteries I had in a TV remote, I should say, the ones I have upstairs in my bedroom. But yeah, the wiring is nice, though. I might have to resort that along, getting proper batteries for this, because I'm currently using batteries, because I don't use rechargeable batteries on my Wiimote as well, because at the end of the day, I don't hardly go on my Wii as much. I go on my Wii now and again, even though just today I've been testing it, because I had to plug this little dongle thing on the bottom of my Wiimote. You just put that in, and that should power it up. As you can see, a red light powers it up, and then you just turn this on the thing, and you just sync it up both together in terms of syncing it up. But yeah, it's a nice unique thing in terms of you know, it does properly work. I had a little go on Super Mario Galaxy 2, and it just properly works. It's just like you know, wireless and all that in terms of I know it looks like a proper knuckle duster, but it was a unique thing. I thought it was a good steal. Even though most sellers on Amazon were selling this product for like nearly up to £10. So yeah, it was a nice product to get overall. And some other things I actually got actually. I ordered this on Amazon, and it's actually the same company that does my analog sticks, because I got some analog sticks to replace my Xbox 360 controller, you know, when I got the Xbox 360 bundle, and I had to replace the analog sticks, because the analog sticks were worn out, and it's actually the same company. I took out most of the packaging, because then it was in this packaging, and then I had to take out the excess packaging from this. But, yeah, I ordered this, which is a 3DS, well, it's a DS case as well. But I ordered this to put my own 3DS games in, because I would like to play on my 3DS a bit more. It's hard, though. You know, since I got Metroid Samus Returns and Pokemon Silver now, I'm trying my very best to get back into my 3DS, even though I'm trying to play on my Nintendo Switch a bit more as well. But knowing me, owning multiple consoles is another thing, like operating systems, like I said. Which, speaking about the Nintendo Switch, I ordered like this, a 3-meter USB Type-C cable, even though it does say fast charging here on the, I don't know if you can see by the glare, fast charging, 2-amp fast charge and all that. But it's a 3-meter cable. I ordered this, it was quite cheap, like around £3-ish, even though the other product, which is the Foamote, the 1-meter cable that I got from Foamote, if you may recall, remember that from when I ordered that. But yeah, it's a different company though. I haven't tried this out yet in terms of, but it's a nice 3-meter cable. It's really nice. It will be good for when I take my Switch to Mum's, and if I can do, it just saves me charging when I go home, because every time I come back from Mum's and when I need to charge it, I have to charge it in the background when I'm playing on my Xbox, and then go back on the Switch to see if it's charged. You know, my Switch is charged or not. But this will be nice though, so I can have a quick charge before I get home, in terms of, and charging it when I get home is another thing. But yeah, it's quite, oh, that won't fit in my Mario zip bag. We'll have to see on the outcome. But yeah, it's a nice cable, not bad for £3. I haven't tested it though, but we'll have to see how it goes. So yeah, as I said, I had a great week overall, even though the videos I did this past week, and get some nice things. Thanks Mum, even at the end of the day, like I said, it's out of my account. Because I don't want to explain these sort of things, because building controversy is another thing, because I know what people are like these days in terms of getting backlash, which I haven't been getting much backlash in terms of this and that lately. I always don't want to go on topic about that. But yeah, even though I had a great week overall, I've been slightly a bit down, because like I said a few vlogs back, I've been recently seeing my doctor, and I really reduced my medication really low. Even myself, I've been a bit low, because I'm still smiley, still smiles all around, even though when I do my YouTube videos, I always bring a positive vibe. I've always been positive in terms of doing my YouTube videos. You can tell by my voice that I am quite positive. But it's I don't know, even though yesterday in general, I was slightly down, and I just wanted to talk to people, even though I was trying to talk to someone locally. But we've been having like conversation issues. Even now, I've been talking to Adrian, I've been talking to other people and all that, even though, you know, my social awkwardness as it is. But like I said, I had a great week, so I can't complain, even though that's in this and that as it is. But yeah, I've just been a bit low in terms of that, but I'm all right. It's just then, like I said, it might be because my really low medication I've been taking has just slightly been a bit off. But also, smiles all around, I'm quite happy as it is. Let alone videos I'm looking forward to doing next week. So yeah, what videos I'll be doing next week? Even though I need to start planning out my monthly video the week after for next month, it is, because it's the last month next week, and I'm looking forward to doing some videos next week, because there'll be an Instagram compilation video, since it's been 3 months since my last Instagram compilation video. I'm looking forward to uploading that, as well as Cuphead is coming out next week, and I'm planning to get on the Xbox One or do some Xbox One gameplay, not in that sort of title, but I'm planning to play it also on my Windows 10 device, since it's a Play Anywhere title. I'm looking forward to getting Cuphead, which I'll be getting next Friday, which will be good. I'm looking forward to getting that, even though recording this vlog on Saturday as it is, because I've been doing that lately in terms of doing vlogs on a Saturday is another thing. But yeah, overall, so that's my vlog for you guys. Hope you're enjoying this vlog and watching to understand it. I hope you guys have a nice rest of your weekend, since we're recording this on Saturday, even though we're recording this vlog next Saturday again, once Cuphead comes out next Friday, is another thing I need to get round to pre-ordering it next week is another thing. But I'm looking forward to playing Cuphead, even I heard it's very, very hard. It's like one of those NES hard games back in the old days. But I'm looking forward to playing it overall. It's a shame it's not, I heard it's not online co-op. It's a shame I can't play with Adrian, because Adrian's planning to get it as well. I heard it's not online co-op. But we'll also see an outcome. We'd like to do some gameplay with him. If you are watching this, Adrian. But we'll have to see in the outcome in terms of that. I'm looking forward to doing some videos next week in general, little, and I need to start doing my production work next week for my monthly video for next month as is. Which I've got something on the pipeline, which I, even though I mentioned to some people, but I don't want to spoil in terms of what I want to plan to do next month for my month video. Anyways, I really ramble on too much. I'll let you guys get on your day. And yeah, do not forget to pop on my social medias or what I've been up to. Anyways, I better go now. See you from Steety Films.